Well, what can government do in terms of industrial policy? I think the debate has been too long bogged down in ideological grandstanding. So, you know, on one side, there were people who said industrial policy never works. On another side, there were people who said that this is the magic bullet. But, you know, the reality is not like that. So I think that we are finally slowly inching towards a more pragmatic attitude, that whatever your official line on industrial policy is, there will be at least an implicit industrial policy, and therefore it might be better to actually make it explicit and bring it out to the open, so that there will be less of this backroom dealings and, you know, implicit subsidies towards certain groups dressed up as some kind of general policy. I think that we are entering a relatively productive phase in this debate, well, after, in my view, 25 years delay, but still better late than never. Now, of course, the difficulty is, yes, okay, we know that the industrial policy can work, we know that it has worked very well in certain circumstances, but how do you learn pragmatic lessons from it? Because all countries are different. Different industries require different kind of supports or the regulatory mechanisms, and therefore you cannot just import the industrial policy in the way that you can import mobile phones or the cars. So that is a big challenge, and we still have some things to learn, but one important lesson I would argue from our debate in the last 25, 30 years is that you first have to have some kind of vision. You know, one way I provocatively put it is, can anyone suggest any reason why the Japanese should be good at making cars? You know, Americans, you can understand, you have a big landmass and you need to get from A to B quickly, so there's a natural incentive to be good at making cars. But in Japan, for God's sake, you don't even have enough land to drive around. So why did Japan become good at making cars, you know? Why are the Swiss good at making chocolates, when they don't grow any cocoa? Yeah? Well, why are the Italians good at roasting coffee when they don't grow bean or coffee? So that my view is that the countries have become good at these things because sometime back, someone, maybe a company, maybe a government, but usually a combination of the two, decided that we are going to become good at these things. So then you try everything to make it happen, and that's how you succeed.